The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hello again, and welcome to the Monday training for the Autodesk BIM 360 Glue mobile iPad app today. We're going to give people a couple minutes to log in here, and then we're going to get started. All right, it's 4 o'clock. I want to welcome everybody here to the Autodesk BIM 360 Weekly Monday Training. Today we're going to be looking at the BIM 360 Glue mobile iPad app. Two things. One, I want to apologize for the confusing emails that went out. I thought I updated the title and I didn't, so I know you received the notification from last week. And the second thing is I had a major iPad crash, and it looks like I'm going to have to get it replaced. So two of the functions aren't going to be able to be shown during the demo. I did confirm with other users of iPads that they work, but until I get this one replaced or at least fixed over at the Apple Store, I'm not going to be able to show them to you today. So we're going to go ahead and get started. And you guys know the ground rules. We're going to be here for 30 minutes or less. We're going to be talking about the mobile iPad app, and everyone is in the muted mode right now. If you have a question, please type it in to the question box. So in respect to Hard Hat Matt, our question of the day is, how many Herbie movies are there? And here we go. Today for our topics of discussion, there's some new features that were released on February 3rd. So there's an updated user experience. You can select object property URLs now. The support for transparent objects in views and markups. And there's a new contextual user assist on the screen. So as we look at this, we wonder why this happened, and what we wanted to do is better align the app. So what we've done is we've optimized the experience for iOS 7, and we've made it a cleaner look so it's closer to the desktop and the browser user experience. And, you know, iOS 7 has a much cleaner look, and so we wanted to go that way. And then, of course, we've now added the content, and we've now made it where you can see the workflows, and actually it will guide you through as you're starting to do things. So that first thing is now inside of the properties, you can add an active URL. So if you've got a pump, you can go in and you can just link them right to that manufacturer's pump or any other object that you have. End users can come, click that URL, and that's going to take you right out to the website that you wanted to go to or the document that's attached out into the world. The second thing is being able to clearly see clashing objects. So now what we've added here is that ability to actually see the transparencies when you're on your iPad. So the end user at the desktop using the desktop application can go in, set up the transparency, set the view up that they want the end user on the iPad to see, save that view, and then when they save that view, you'll be able to open that up on your iPad and mark it up and really respond like any other view, but the transparency will be there. And then there's the coaching marks callouts. So now, as you go in between functions, you're actually going to have callouts on the screen that will actually tell you what you can do and where it is available on the screen. And if you're on this call, you've hopefully received the notification for it, and all of this can be found in the help file. So now we're going to go head over to the demo and take a look at that. And I hope we're all getting that full screen look. And so, let's go ahead and see that. So when we come in now and we want to go to something, let me pull this over to our pumps. Ooh, wavy. Be able to click on the pumps, go into the properties. You'll find the URL here, and this is what isn't showing up on my iPad. But the URL will show up in this area, and you'll be able to click on that, and that will take you out to that particular URL that you've put into place. I'm going to take a look and see. They tried to update this over the phone, but I don't think it did there. So that's where your URL will show up. When you come in now with other functionality, when you want to do a markup, your markups come in, you're set to go, and if you see across the top of the screen, it now gives you clear instructions on what you can do. So here it says tap notify to save and share your markup. So as we come in and we start to do things and mark it up, that set of instructions will be there for you, and then you can save them. And you've now saved that function. The next piece, I'm going to go out of this model, open one up, and let's see if I can get the contextual to come up. One second here. I'm actually going to just change the model and see if I can get it to show up on the first time. So on the first time when you open up that model, the contextual screen should come up. And these are the two problems that I was having on my iPad. It actually caused mine to crash the first time I did it. And the models wouldn't load, even though I've already opened them and loaded them. As I said, we check this with other end users, only happening on my iPad, so I'm going to believe that it's a bug with this one. Let me just go back and see if I can have one more model come in here. Let me shut this off, and I'm going to go back into it. We'll try this one more time. Not going to give me the screen that we need. Let's see. No, not going to pull up on here. So, sorry to say that that's not working on mine. And as I said before, it is only my device that it's not working on. But what our end users will now, what they will now see, and I'm just going to go back to that screen because the function actually works very nice. They will see this whole contextual screen come up, which will give them directions to where everything is and a clear instruction on what it does. And what we'll do next week is I'll actually pick up with those two functionalities, the transparency and this one, and we'll actually demo that for you so you can see that and just... My apologies on the iPad. And that's going to be it for today. That is all of the new functions that are in this current version. And if we have any questions, I would I'd enjoy answering them for you. Two of you did get the answer right for the five Herbie movies. All right, we had one question on the look. I know, you know, they want the look to be as clean as they can, so our end users, when whether they're on your iPad or whether you're on the desktop, that you're getting the same look and the same user experience. So it just brings you closer together, so you're not trying to find something in a different place on the desktop than where it is on the iPad. I hope that answers your question. Any other questions from anyone? All right, well, if there's no more questions, as I said, my apologies for the iPad. We will pick this up again next week. I'll pick up with those two demos on the contextual screen and with the transparency, and we'll go ahead with our next topic. So thank you, everyone, for attending today.